Hey guys, John from the John Muir Show here. Now, we all know that creepy Uncle Joe, former U.S. Vice President Joe Biden, is one of the roughly two dozen Democrats seeking his party's nomination for the presidency in 2020. And as part of his campaign, Mr. Biden, just this past Monday, well, in Iowa, unveiled his health care plan. And now, there's no way this can be serious. I mean, Biden, he's just got to be joshing us. There is no way he actually meant what he was saying. Look, I want to make sure I get this right. I want to make sure I have the direct quote from Biden for you. So you had Biden in Iowa this past Monday talking healthcare, saying, quote, "If you like your healthcare plan, your employer-based plan, you can keep it. If you like your private insurance, you can keep it," end quote. That coming from, again, former U.S. Vice President Joe Biden. Does it sound kind of familiar, what he had just said? I mean, it should ring a bell, because that sounds very similar to what the guy that Biden used to share the ticket with would always say. That would be our former President Barack Obama. I mean, time and time and time and time again, during the Obama years, you had Obama running around the country saying, if you like your plan, you can keep it. If you like your provider, you can keep your provider. I mean, he said that over and over and over again when he was trying to pitch Obamacare to everyone in the United States. And what happened? Oh yeah, it turned out to be a massive lie. I mean, that lie on the part of former President Obama, it was so bad that even leftist PolitiFact came out and named it its 2013 lie of the year. That's how bad of a lie it was, what Obama was saying with, you can keep your provider, you can keep your plan, because you couldn't. And now you got Biden, the guy who was Obama's vice president, saying the same damn thing. Why is it we should take Joe Biden seriously? I mean, clearly Joe Biden, when he was in the White House as Obama's vice president, he didn't push to allow people to keep their providers, to keep their plans. So why should we believe now as president that he's going to fight for people to keep their providers or keep their plan if they would like to do so? There's no reason why we should believe that. Look, contrary to what one of our guests said on the John Muir Show today, Joe Biden's not this tough guy who's going to fight tirelessly for the well-being of United States citizens. No, that's not who Joe Biden is. See, Joe Biden and his style of leadership, we've learned, is very similar to Barack Obama's style of leadership. Because, look, under Obama, the United States of America was an absolute disaster. I mean, the economy was in the toilet. That was the doing of Barack Obama. The U.S. standing on the global stage, that was in the toilet, also the doing of Barack Obama. He had our economy in tatters. He was going around the world apologizing for the United States. I mean, you had foreign countries taking advantage of the United States left and right, and Obama just let it happen, didn't seem to have a problem with it, and Biden was there for the entire thing. He had a chance to do something, but he didn't. He allowed that to be the reality of his country, the United States. I mean, there is no reason for us to believe that things are going to be any different if Biden goes from being the number two guy, like he was under Obama, to being the number one guy if he wins the presidency in 2020. No. You see, we had a failure that was Barack Obama, and Fortunately, President Trump in the past 2.5 years, he has made the United States of America a much better place. He has rescued us from the failures of Barack Obama. The economies went from being in the toilet to absolutely flourishing. The United States is back to the pinnacle of the world standing. We're respected and feared again. I mean, Trump has righted all of these Obama wrongs. But if we go with Joe Biden, if Joe Biden gets elected in 2020, we're going to get right back to where we were under Barack Obama, where the United States is struggling, where the United States is the laughingstock of the world. And all my fellow patriots out there, regardless of how you may vote in past elections, we do not want that to happen. Now, do we? That's all the time that we have for today, but tune into the John Muir Show each and every weekday, 8:40 a.m. WTAQ, 9 a.m. WSAU and WHBL. Till next time, I'm out.